Hi, Nuno, good to see you. Can you just give us an insight into the mood, the atmosphere around the place after Sunday? What have you said to the players?
Obviously, the mood is not good. We are sad, disappointed, but it's a feeling that we have to realize that we have to, that is with us, that goes home with us, that doesn't allow us to sleep, but only can make us stronger to react, and the reaction is tomorrow.
Just on Harry Kane, Nuno, still no Premier League goal for him, of course. Are you worried about his form, and do you think it's a hangover of what happened in the summer, or effectively what didn't happen in the summer?
What happened is the past. What I'm worried about is on loan with the team. We want the best of all our players. We want the best of Harry, we want the best of all of them. And only with the best of all of us, we can go through this situation.
Just last couple from me, Nuno. There's been lots of talk about the Tottenham DNA, the Tottenham way, the Tottenham philosophy. Do you know what it is? Have you been told what it is? And do you feel your philosophy matches Tottenham's?
I've been told, and everybody knows, and it's football. Everybody wants to play good. Everybody wants to play offensive. Everybody wants to score. This is what we chase. Sometimes it's not possible, but we are aware that this is how we want to do. But it takes a building process to achieve it, and we are trying.
Just a final one from me. Lo Celso and Romero have been called up to the Argentina squad. If the quarantine rules can't be changed, will you take any steps potentially to stop them going, or would you expect them to put the club first and not go?
Yes, what we expect is what we are concerned about is the government bodies make a decision to that can protect the clubs on these international breaks. What we don't want is to the same situation repeat again. So we don't have our players. And what you are asking me, I always say, it's very difficult to say no to a national team. It's never been the case before. We are facing this situation through the pandemic. So what we want is protection. Us as clubs, we need decisions that protect us because we want to have our players in national team and we want them available for us also.
Thank you.
Thank you, Darmish.
Thanks, Darmish. George Cummings from BBC, please.
Thanks, Anthony. Nuno, just on that, are you calling now on FIFA and UEFA to help you because it's something as a club that you can't solve yourself and you need them to almost make the decision for the players that they can't go? Is that what you're asking for?
Some guidance. We have been to this problem before, and we don't want the situation to repeat. What we want is, and we know everybody knows that there are conversations going on between all the government bodies to solve the situation. What we cannot afford is to have our players out again.
Can I just ask, so this is two questions in one, really. Are you worried that they might have to go to Croatia again? Is that what you're worried about? And just as a side, could you get some team news, please? Are your players
What
back?
we sorry I lost the last party you
Sorry,
asked.
and just some team news, please, about Bergwijn, whether he's going to be fit. But were you worried about the players going to Croatia again?
No, I'm not even considering that scenario because what we want is the situation solved before, some guidance before, so we can communicate to our players and tell the best way to deal with the situation. In terms of team news, nothing has changed. Steve is unfortunately still out. He cannot join the group.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, George. Ian Abrahams from TalkSport, please.
Hi, Nuno. How are you?
Hello, Ian.
Is this job at Spurs tougher than you thought it would be when you were given it in the summer?
All the jobs are tough in our profession. As managers, there's no easy job. There's no easy task.
But you got a lot of criticism on Sunday. You came out and took the criticism on your shoulders. But for a manager who's only been in a new job for a couple of months. That's highly unusual. Normally you get much more of a honeymoon period.
The criticism is normal. And you've been in football, I've been in football, everybody that is on the screen knows how this industry works. When you don't play good, when you don't perform and the results don't go along, criticism is something that you have to deal with that. So we understand it, and it's up to us to react it, to change it.
So you know football and I know football. How big a game is this one now and the one at the weekend with Newcastle? Going into an international break, you need to change things around, don't you?
Of course. And you need to change it today and tomorrow and the day after, because this is the moment that we have to react. We have to react. It's not, as you can imagine, it's no good. It's no good. Feeling this way, like we are feeling now, like our fans are feeling now, it's not good. But the difference between us and our fans, that we can change it. We can change it. It's up to us to change it.
Good luck. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Thanks, Ian. Alistair Gold, please.
Hey there, Nuno.
Hello.
Just going to ask you, obviously, you've spoken in the past about how you haven't been able to train with a lot of the players. You're using matches to train them. I mean, is it fair for people to judge you yet? Or, I mean, I guess what I'm saying is, how long until we see the actual Nuno Espirito Santo Tottenham that you want to have out there?
Alistair, there's no judgment. I'm not worried about the judgment. What I'm worried is about how can we play better? How can we play better? The judgment and the criticism and the opinion and all of that is part of it. And we have to deal with that. We have to deal with that. And that doesn't interfere in the way we work. It can only distract us. So I'm very simply telling you that my focus is how can we improve? How can we improve? In terms of the fans, now is not moment to ask them. Of course, we need them. We need their support because the players and the team needs the support of the fan. But it's not moment to ask them. It's moment to deliver. Now we have to give them so they feel again good with the team. They feel they see a team that is solid and is playing good, and things go back to normal.
Well, I mean, on the second part of my question, I guess, is, as we know.
Yeah, sorry, you mentioned about the time and the preparation. Yes, of course, we have, since the beginning of the season, we have unbalanced situations, players that have a lot of sessions, players that have not so many sessions, that arrive late, players that were international break, players that get injured. So a lot of issues, but this is how we have to know that we have a squad, we have to manage, we have to take advantage of the games to improve, because we are in the process of recovering and playing. So the matches are important for us to get back in the best level of fitness, improve our performances, put inside the ideas that we want in the pitch. A match is always a good chance to do it.
I guess what I'm asking is, it's just how long until we get what you want to see on the pitch? I mean, how long does this process take?
Hopefully tomorrow. Hopefully tomorrow. It's always the next football gives you the next chance to put things right. It's the next match. And the next match is tomorrow. Tomorrow.
Okay. Thank you, Nuno.
Thanks, Ali. Jonathan Veal, please.
Hi, Nuno. On paper, Moura are the weakest team you'll face in the group stage. Will tomorrow be a chance to see a few of the younger players? Might Dane Scarlett be involved, for example?
Yeah, we have to make the decisions. But all the squad is going together. Obviously, without telling you too much, there will be some changes because they are required. And because I think for us, regarding Thursday and Sunday, is the best way. But I will not go much further than that. I'm sorry.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks, Johnny. Adrian Kajumba, please.
Hi, Nuno. I just wanted to ask you about something you mentioned last week about the heading. I just wondered, have you heard back from the Premier League yet?
Yeah, I know that maybe I was not very fortunate to say that. I just honestly try to tell the reality. It's very difficult in terms of training session to prevent and to avoid heading the ball because it's part of the game. What we can do is try to manage the days, and we are trying, but as you all know, and you may ask this question to all the managers in football, we cannot stop heading. We cannot stop heading because it's part of the game. So if you are playing a small side game and the ball goes in the air, tell me if does it make sense to say, don't head it. It's absurd. So what we are trying is to prevent this action to repeat over and over and over again, because we are aware that can cause dementia, and we don't want to provoke any kind of harm to our players. But at the same time, it's very hard to avoid it.
Have you, can I just confirm, have you actually spoken to the Premier League about it and maybe put your position to them?
I think they know. What I'm trying to tell you is that it's something so simple and so natural. They send us a guidance to all the clubs, but what I'm saying, us as managers, tell me how can I say no to a player that's going to head the ball? I repeat, so it has to be some kind of tolerance on that aspect.
Thanks very much, Nuno.
Thank you.
Jack Pitbrook, please.
Hi, Nuno. You were very honest on Sunday about the problem with your game plan at Arsenal. Do you intend to change your plan or your tactics this week?
I'm changing all the games as a different plan. All the games, because all the opponents are different. Something that repeats is our idea. And I was honest on Sunday, and if I have to be honest again, I will do it. What I'm doing now is avoid being honest in the end of the game. So make my decisions right.
Do you think the solution is just communication with your players then?
More?
Yeah.
We speak every day, many, many times.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jack.
Thanks, Jack.
Right, there's three left with their hands up, so we will finish with those three. So Tony Banks, please.
Hi, Nuno.
Hello, Tony.
Just to follow on from what Jack was saying there, after three league defeats that you've had, is it, and you were, as you say, you were very honest after the game on Sunday, is it a question of the making sure that the players not only understand but believe in what you are trying to do as a coach and the system and the philosophy? They have to believe, don't they? Do they totally believe yet, do you think?
Yeah, totally believe. Totally believe. Totally. There's no doubts about that, because we work together every day. We prepare it together. And in these moments, we have to stick together. And what you say, and rightly so, the belief is the first step to do things. And we have it. We have it. Now, we have to realize that sometimes it's not possible. Why? Because sometimes your opponent is better than you, and you have to be humble and give credit to that, as many times it's hard to do so. And sometimes you don't perform. You don't perform. And sometimes the plan is no good. So, but the belief in all of us is here.
And, you know, the government is telling people in this country not to panic because there's no petrol in the petrol stations now. Is it the same? Don't panic. You know, we will get this right in the end with you, with your team.
We don't panic. We don't panic because we know, at least I know, that this is football. This is football. This is football. It's how you react to the bad moments, because it's something that you cannot avoid. And you go through history, unfortunately, every team goes to a moment like this. The sooner we get out of that, better. And tomorrow we have to go out. We have to win. We have to play better. We have to compete better. But sticking together is the only way to do it.
Thanks, Nuno, and good luck.
Thank you, Tony.
Thanks, Tony. Paul Jiggins, please.
Hi, Nuno. Can I first ask, is this competition a help or a hindrance as you look to put things right at Tottenham?
It's what it is. We are involved and we are on it and we are committed to it. Like I said, from the first game that we play in the playoff in Portugal, we are committed to it. All the games are important for us.
And for me as well, last one for me, can I ask how the players took your criticism of them after Sunday's match? Were they obviously not happy about it, but how did they take the criticism of them?
You have to ask them, Paul. What I believe when you don't perform the way we want, you want the best, and the first step that you have to do is to analyze yourself. Take a good look inside, see, and go from there. And I repeat, what we are feeling and what we felt on Sunday is bad, is very bad, because the team is not playing good, because we are not happy. And this feeling stays with us every minute of our days, every minute of our days, until we go out of that. And tomorrow we have to go it.
Thank you.
Thanks, Paul. Thank you, Paul. Final question to Rahman Osman, please.
Hi, Nuno. I'm sure Hello. You would have maybe touched on a bit, but I just wanted to ask this. They say in adversity, you get to know your team better. So you started winning games. This difficult period, what does it tell you about the team and the crop of players you have?
A lot of things. It tells me a lot of things. Since day one, we are knowing each other better. We are realizing our strengths, our weaknesses, so we can improve. The moment that we were winning was only disguising to the outside. Inside, we knew that we had still things to improve. Now, it's obvious that we have things to improve. And in terms of what I'm seeing players that want to achieve, that work hard to achieve it, and we are not able to be consistent to do it. We still have a problem when we concede a goal. We lost, we lose our focus, we lose our solid, how compact we are, and that we must avoid. So a lot of analysis is going on, a lot of an analysis. But with the true belief that we have a talent squad and quality players to go out of this situation and play much better football.
Yeah, and then just finally, and just a follow, because you said that the first win you knew. Did you anticipate that the difficulty will come after three games, though?
Sorry, I don't understand, Raman. Sorry.
So did you anticipate that even though you started winning three games, you started with three wins in the Premier League, did you anticipate that this period will come as soon as it's come?
No, we don't anticipate. When you are okay, what you try to do is to throw it in front of you, always going, try to avoid a bad game or a bad performance. You don't anticipate this. You don't anticipate. You only know when you are in debt.